Hello everyone, today I'm just going to be going over how to get a brand new Nelgaf pet that actually released for everyone to be able to get, so you don't have to be a member or have actual Nelgaf items to actually get this pet. So it's quite simple to get, and the reason it's actually released for everyone is because it was basically a Twitter retweet deal that Artix did, I believe, where if the tweet that was tweeted out, or the image, or what it was, got 1,000 retweets, then a pet would have came out from Nelgaf, made from himself, for everyone to actually use. So, let's get started. To actually get this pet, you want to go slash join Evil War Null. And once you are at Evil War Null, you can then tool to Dilly Gas here and press on the favor shop. And then you'll go to the pet section and you'll actually see the pet, or two pets actually. If it'll open up for me. Okay, there we go. So there's the Bloodsucker of Nelgaf, which is actually the evolved version of the other pet, which is the Nelgaf's Bloodsucker larvae. So you would just buy the Nelgaf's Bloodsucker larvae, and as you can see here, it's free, and it's AC tagged, non-member, and then you can use it to merge the Bloodsucker of Nelgaf. You also need one Bone Dust, which is actually extremely easy to get, since you can just go slash join Battle Under B, and just kill one of the undead warriors there, for as you can see there, it dropped some bone dust. That's pretty simple and self-explanatory. So once you do have the bone dust, you can then go back to Evil War Null and turn it in. So let's try Evil War Null. And then you'll be able to turn in the Nelgaf Bloodsucker larvae and the one bone dust and get the Bloodsucker of Nelgaf pet. And then you can just buy the Nelgaf Bloodsucker larvae again and have both of the pets together. As you can see, they are actually awesome rarities, so I don't think they'll be going rare. And they'll probably stay around in the game just so everyone can actually get them. So, that's pretty cool. I'll go ahead and actually equip them so you can see how they look like, how big they are, and all that, their walking animations and things like that, so be right back. Alright, so I just went to pink map so you can actually see the pet easier than if you went to white map. So this is how big the pet actually is compared to my character, so it's quite small. So this is Nelgaf's Bloodsucker larvae, as you can see here, it's walk cycle, it crawls around, and has a little rune underneath it. So it's pretty cool. Now I'll go ahead and put the Bloodsucker on, the Bloodsucker of Nelgaf. So here's the Bloodsucker of Nelgaf. As you can see, it's a bit bigger and has fins and stuff like that. It also has the crawling walk cycle, but overall it's pretty cool, especially for a little free pet from Nelgaf, which is quite a treat. So definitely go ahead and pick it up if you can, because you can pick it up whenever, because I don't think it's going rare, as I said, but still, just try and get it if you can. It's pretty cool to have. That's pretty much all that I really wanted to talk about when it comes to these two pets here. So now I'm at Akiba for the Year of the Dog, so the celebration of Akiba New Year. As you can see, the place has been updated with the Year of the Dog stuff. There are no rare items for the Year of the Dog this year. For some reason, I'm not exactly sure why. They've usually done it every year, but it seems it just hasn't happened this year. So, the house shop, I believe, has some new stuff. The Year of the Dog fireworks, which when clicked, usually will actually be animated. I can't actually buy them at the moment, though, to show their animation. But pretty much they look exactly like the ones in the map here. They just shoot out little sparks. I can't buy them since I don't have any house space right now. So there's the fireworks, the Year of the Dog scroll in kanji, and the year, just the normal Year of the Dog scroll. And then over here we actually have a new boss that's in here, which is from Zhongchang, and when you translate it, it actually translates to loyalty. So he actually does drop quite a few items. He drops his tail, his dual katanas, and he also drops a single version of his katana. And those are all non-member. He also has a chance to drop the Yellow Foo Dog Morph and the Year of the Dog Open Helm, I believe. Those two are also both non-member. He also can drop these cross katanas, or Zhongchang's cross katana cape, which he can also drop and is non-member. And then he can also drop the Yellow Foo Dog Pet, which is member. So I can actually show you a few of the drops, since I did get a few. I don't have all of them, however, but I can go ahead and do that. You can also drop Zhongchang's katana in Scabbard, and a Zhongchang pet, which I also do have. I have the pet. So I'll go ahead and go to Yelga and just put the stuff on. But before I do that, I'll just show you here. He's level 50, 4-star difficulty, 75,000 HP. So, he doesn't actually hit that hard, his attack range is actually quite low, so you won't probably need a lot of help unless you want to kill him faster, but that's about it. So here's Zhongchang's cross katanas, Zhongchang's tails, or tail, Yellow Foo Dog pet, and the Zhongchang pet, which actually the eyes change according to your eye color. But yeah, so those are the drops that I have, but there are a few more that he also drops, which I do not have. Now, other than the Akiba New Year stuff, the Bello Pesario and the Ultra Bello actually drop a new set this year, which is the Honra Selvigum set, made by Daniel PP2. And most of the items of the set are actually non-member. The only item that is actually member is the bow, the short bow. There's quite a few items with the set. I don't actually have any of the items, so I can't really show you. I'm quite sorry about that. It's actually a set that's based off of the North American Indians. So it's quite colorful and has headdresses and things like that. Very feathery and a lot of markings, and it's quite a nice set made by Daniel PP2, and it's pretty cool that they actually added it to the game. The items are not AC tagged, but both Bello Pesario and Ultra Bello drop the same items, so obviously if you want to get the items fast, just go for the normal version, not the Ultra. But other than that, that's pretty much everything I want to talk about. That's just an update on everything that's actually came out, basically. So, other than that, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.